Hey everyone, this is the LEGO DC Comics Superheroes Justice League Knightcrawler Tunnel Attack Set. Yeah, another one of those with a really long name. The vehicle itself, the Knightcrawler, had a really nice build. Nothing too fancy with the design in terms of the types of parts used or the types of techniques used, but it was enjoyable for me to put together. Had a minimal reliance on just small stickers for detail. Most of the detail is good stuff. They actually have some printed pieces along the sides, and this seems like a really fun toy to me. I believe in universe it's supposed to use four different basically like tank tread sections, but they've approximated those with these fairly flat tires instead, which honestly are much better for the sake of play because they can roll much more easily. And this thing has a bunch of articulation because these are supposed to be like arms, so it can get to a point where it can walk if it needs to. Now, it only has joints here and here on either side. Does not have the ability to articulate in closer. It would have been nicer if you could have articulated in there, but let me go ahead and open this up a little bit more. Maybe I'll keep these in farther, bring this forward a little bit so you can see how it can kind of lean to one side depending upon exactly how you pose everything up. But it just seems like a really cool thing to me. It's like partially robotic, you know, mech-like, like a four-legged mech in a way. But then let me see if I can get this into a... I don't think I can get it into a three... Oh yeah, I can. There we go. Three-legged pose, like that. Kind of looks more like it's walking like that. But then it also has the wheels as well, the tires, and they have, you know, actual rubber tires on them, which help this to run more smoothly over all sorts of different surfaces. So I just like that. It just seems fun to me. It seems like a cool design. It does have action features built into it with the stud shooters. It's got the twin six stud shooters, which, you know, just blast studs everywhere. They do give you two full sets of extra studs in the set as well, because you will certainly end up losing at least a couple of those. They tend to get stuck in like the baseboard, right around the edges of your carpeting. It's where they tend to get lost. But see the level of detail with just the textures of pieces themselves, you know, even using the modified tiles over here, where you get some tiled area and then you get some studded area. These are the printed pieces that I was mentioning, the one-by-one tiles there, the round ones with just the circles and silver printed onto them. You know, these give you some texture here. These are interesting looking parts. I appreciate that they covered up the edges of these kind of elbow joints, if you will, with just a tile on either side. Could have done without some of the blue stuff, but honestly, it doesn't bug me too much. It's just a little bit, and this is one of those cases where it almost feels like it adds just a little bit of extra detail by it. You know, I'm not making everything just black and gray, which can get boring. Of course, the canopy section is not just black and gray. That's a nice transparent red piece. Let me get this figure in there so you can see how that looks. See, that's a pretty cool look, actually, having Batman behind that flat canopy piece, because, you know, everything inside becomes tinted red when you have this up. And this has pretty nicely shaped gaps around the edges of it. You know, everything fits together pretty respectably well, but it's still easy to open this up to get access into the cockpit. I didn't put his cape in there just perfectly, but of course that figure does obviously have the newer style of cape, so it's not going to get all crinkled up, and he's not attached with any studs to the base in there. It's just using one of those panel pieces, the 1x2 panel piece, to kind of wedge in between his legs, which is very convenient. And there are just a couple stickers on either side. I think this is done pretty decently well. All told, I just think this is a really cool thing. It's kind of ugly. I think that it's hard to disagree with that. But I think it's ugly in a good way, where it's got that whole function over form thing going with it. You know, it has a little bit of organic nature with the kind of spider-like stance, but at the same time, you know, it's clearly mechanical. Looks like it could almost have a little bit of sentient life itself. And though it doesn't have a lot that it'll actually do, again, I think that it makes for a good toy. This version of the Batman is pretty good. The suit has that texture on it, which is metallic, but yet it's not overdone. You know, it's not too thick. The individual little bits of paint application are not too large. So I think that just works out pretty well. He does come with the grappling hook gun and a Batarang, plus there's a spare in the set. I forgot to show you that you can actually attach both of those to the back of the Knightcrawler itself. And then here's the new Flash, who comes with a couple of the Power Blast pieces. This is a pretty good looking figure, pretty good print on it as well. Also like the paint application on the helmet. And a good print is there on the back. I like the shaping of that helmet, especially around the back. I actually like these views of it better than the front, because this is a little bit generic. You know, a lot of the Lego helmets that have eye holes have that exact same shape that starts to make different heroes and villains alike look a little bit the same in their faces. But this is more unique back here. And you also get alternate faces for each of these, and get a nice, actually really nice print for Batman on the back as well, which just follows the texture from the front. The only thing that I don't like about the Flash here is the skin tone color. I mean, he has nice print around the edges of the suit, around the edges of the face there, but the skin tone is very pale. Now, keep in mind that I believe these are supposed to be the same tones. I may be mistaken on that, but I think they're supposed to be the same. But obviously they used a different color on the right, and it's still not the pale color. Maybe they were actually going for kind of a medium color here, but this is definitely not the standard pale color. It's a little bit whiter, and also there's a little bit of red coming through. You know, it ends up being a little bit pinkish. So it has always been an issue, you know, printing on darker things. It obviously will continue to be an issue, but beyond that, just that color there, I think both of these figures are done pretty well. And then what do we have here? Couple of Hades, yeah. Couple of Parademons, yeah. These guys are not done pretty well. These guys are done fantastically well. This is just so unfair that for this series, Lego has made these generic unnamed baddies so cool. The vinyl pieces, interestingly, and I don't know if this is going to be the case for every single set that's out there, but I got two of the vinyl piece, the vinyl sheet, each of which includes one small wing set and one large wing set. So potentially I could set up both of these with the small wings, or both of them with the large wings. I don't know if that's the intent, but very frequently Lego does that, where they include an extra vinyl sheet when there is one that's attached to the set at all, in order to ensure that if one of them gets bent, you know, terribly, you'll still be able to have a good piece. But those prints just have so much detail in them, all around the whole figure, everything about them, and so much depth with the darker tones that are used in there as well. And with one of the wing pieces removed completely, you can better appreciate the great print that continues all the way around to the back, even though most of the time you're not going to see that, because you're going to leave these cool wings on, or, you know, maybe you'll swap them out and you'll be able to see that print during that time while you're swapping them. But, you know, most of the time you're not going to appreciate this, but it's there, and if you look at it, it is definitely to be appreciated, I think. Lastly, the set comes with another mother box, the gray one this time. It's dark gray, has the textured masonry bricks used on the sides, and that is a print on the top. No sticker used there. Has a little bit of metallic printing in it, and that's just really well done. It's just a nice looking piece that I feel could be used for things other than just this specific theme. So I like pretty much everything in this set, and then I look at the price to part ratio, and that looks pretty fantastic as well. However, I'd say the price to volume of stuff ratio, you know, how much you pay for how much stuff in total that you get, the size of everything put together, is not fantastic. Definitely much lower than lower in value, looking at it that way, than just looking at the price to part ratio. I think the price to part ratio is definitely skewed a bit by the number of small pieces, the stud pieces. You know, they've got, was it 24 of those? No, 28 of those officially. for just the stud shooters in the set, and then they've got, you know, detail pieces and a lot of Technic pins and stuff. But I think overall, especially given that they do include four figures and all four of them are pretty good, it works out pretty well. I wouldn't mind seeing this go down in price a little bit, but as it is right now, relative to other sets on the market, the value seems to be pretty respectable. So there you go. Those are my thoughts on the LEGO DC Comics Superheroes Justice League Knightcrawler Tunnel Attack Set. Blah. I've got a lot more videos to bring you, so I'll be talking to you again very soon.